And if you take in the evolution, see generally the arrangement of phylogeny in the form of tree. The arrangement of phylogeny in the form of tree was first proposed by Haeckel. Means, for example, like this. How the phylogeny takes place. So the arrangement of phylogeny in the form of tree was started by Haeckel scientist. Okay. So this is the biological classification. So next thing, if you see, hierarchy classification. Hierarchy classification. See, if you take hierarchy classification, in the hierarchy classification, it includes a topic or word known as systematics. Sir, actually systematics was started by Linnaeus scientist. So that is why Linnaeus is considered as founder of modern systematics. Sir, systematics is little bit a big word than the taxonomy. Systematic is bigger than the taxonomy. Sir, what systematic reveals us? Systematics, it is a branch of biology that reveals you trends in the evolution and relationship in the evolutionary organisms or among the organisms. Sir, when you take taxonomy or when you take classification, animals are classified into different groups only. But it is systematics, it also reveals trends in evolution. How the evolution is taking place, how the new species may come, and this species will develop into what type of new species. So that kind of trends also revealed by the systematics. And also systematics gives you relationship among the organisms. So that is why systematics is called as molecular taxonomy. Systematics is called as molecular taxonomy, in which trends in evolution, relationship among the organisms are studied in the systematics. So systematics, it is bigger than the taxonomy, and that was started by the Carolus Linnaeus scientist. So that is why Linnaeus is called as founder of modern systematics. Sir, here hierarchical classification. Generally, hierarchical classification means here there are different types of categories will be present. There are different types of categories are present. That categories are called as obligatory taxa. They are called as obligatory taxa or obligatory categories. Obligatory categories. So here there are seven obligatory categories are there. Are seven obligatory taxa are there. So what are those seven obligatory taxa? Let us see. First obligatory taxa is kingdom. Second obligatory taxon is phylum. Third one is class. Fourth one is order. Fifth one is family. Sixth one is genus. Seventh one is species. Sir, here the entire organisms are divided into seven obligatory categories or seven obligatory taxa. So the first obligatory taxon is kingdom. Kingdom is divided into phylum. Phylum is divided into class. Class is divided into order. Orders divided into families. Family is divided into genera. Genus is divided into different types of species. So not only these obligatory taxa, so there are some intermediate categories. There are some intermediate categories. Sir, if you take some intermediate categories,
generally sub kingdom. Okay, next grade, division, subdivision. Next, subphylum, superclass, subclass, superorder, suborder. Okay, so these are all the intermediate categories. Next, superfamily. Next, subfamily. Okay, so there are no super genus and sub genus. There is no super species, only next subspecies. So these are the intermediate categories. These are the intermediate categories. So subkingdom, grade, division, subdivision, subphylum, superclass, subclass, superorder, suborder, superfamily, subfamily, and subspecies. So these are the intermediate categories. So these are the obligatory taxa and these are intermediate categories. Means the organisms are divided into these type of obligatory taxa as well as intermediate categories. For example, most of these obligatory taxa. So kingdom, class, order, genus, species. So all of these were proposed by Linnaeus scientist. So Carolus Linnaeus proposed the word kingdom, class, order, family, genus, not the family, genus and species. If you take phylum word, the word phylum was proposed by Haeckel. So these are the obligatory taxa.